Hey, Blue Table fans, just going to show you a conversion really quick. Well, it's not really a conversion, it's more of a kit bash. This is a Carnifex for my fungus nids. This is the stand-in for two twin link devourers, which I've explained on previous videos is a pretty it's problematic. That's the word I'm looking for. So this is just our standard level three work. The carapace is a prime, an overspray, a heavy dry brush, a wash, and then a highlight. It's pretty straightforward stuff. Same thing typically on the skin. And I love this color scheme. It's not for everybody, but the colors could easily be rearranged on this. I thought of doing it with green carapace, and of course you could change the flesh tones. With Tyranids, there's two basic ways you can attack it. You can do dark flesh tones with light carapace, but the more common one is dark carapace with light flesh tones, and you can go all the way almost up to white with that. So here's a second one that I did. Rawr! So it's a pair. It's a pair of Carnifexes. I'll probably do a third one on there. And so this piece comes from the Turvagon kit, and it is one of the three options that you can have on the four limbs. It's called a flesh borer hive. It's pretty much the option you're not gonna use. And in fact, it's for the Tyranifex. The flesh borer hive goes on the Tyranifex. So usually this piece is an extra. So let me show you the other options. So you get this oversized scything talon. I would never use that. I would definitely get crushing claws. They get plus D3 attacks. That's the option on this just assembled Turvagon. So that's the kit you get. That's what you get with the kit. In fact, let's do a little size comparison here. So side by side, that's about how big they are. Against each other. In fact, let me just go out just a tad wider here. So that's about how the two kits stack up. All right, just thought I'd show you one more Carnifex. This is a fully magnetized version. This is for a client. This has very much earth tones. It's got not much of a value contrast between the skin and the carapace. This is probably client request. Plus there's a lot of light coming in, so you can't see that the carapace is actually a slight greenish color. In fact, let me just, can I get rid of the light somehow here? There you go. See, isn't that better? So the little splash of green makes a big difference. Again, this is our stock level three, rated level 3 out of 10 on Blue Table Painting scale of 0 to 10. And quite frankly, a level 3 is the best bang for your buck. And it is probably ahead of the curve if you take all the models that are painted out there. I call it Wargamer standard. In any case, so this guy just has splashes of color on him, which makes a little more exciting. So let's take a look at some of the magnetization. You got a Stranglethorn cannon, and of course you have to also magnetize this piece. Hello, there you go. Oh, that's a little bit better. Okay, so here's the same guy, but with crushing claws and scything talons. Now, in this case, you get 4 attacks base, reroll ones, plus D3 attacks. That's about 6 attacks. You'll probably, on average, roll 1-1, that is possibly a conversion. So that is not a bad melee combination for a Carnifex. Again, I just put this on here as an example of how you would use more earth tones to create a slightly more natural looking effect. Me personally, I like my Tyranids brightly colored. I want to point out just one more alteration on this guy, which is Tyranids have 6 limbs, so I can't, even though this represents 2 sets of limbs, I can't just leave this one spot blank. So I used a little bit of green stuff, and I put this tiny little smallest of the Ravener claws as a vestigial limb on there. So anyway, that is what I have to say about Carnifexes and kit bashing. So thank you for tuning in, and I hope you got your inspiration for the day.